God, I hope I'm not too late. Hello, Buffalo, Western New York. I am Nadine, coming to you from Toronto, Canada, via Niagara Falls. We're here at the Fallsview Casino Resort, and tonight there's a huge opening, the Dragonfly Nightclub. I don't know if you heard about it by now, but it's going to be slamming. It's going to be jumping. So we're going to get to the club and talk to the man behind the scene. Talk to the man that's taking the club scene from Toronto all the way across the border. We're going to see what kind of footprint he's going to be leaving in the U.S. of A. I'm talking about Charles Khabouth. We're going to talk to his design team. We're going to talk about the photographers. We're going to talk about everybody responsible for making this night the night that it is. Let's go on in. Woo! Hi, guys. Most powerful figure in the club culture and the party social scene. This is Charles Khabouth. We are not worthy. How are you?
Excellent. Very good. Very good.
Now here's the man that runs the city of Toronto, and rumor has it he kind of inked some kind of multi-million-dollar deal that's getting his self-made club empire closer to the border. We haven't crossed the border yet, but Niagara Falls, you know, pretty close. But he's the king of clubs, no pun intended. We are at Falls Casino. So Charles, for the Buffalo people, for the folks, everybody's hearing about all these nightclubs that one man has been running for the longest period of time. We'll get into this later. But how did this actual nightclub come about before we talk about your other clubs?
Well, this club we've been working on the last couple of years, and we always wanted to do something inside of a casino, and this casino is pretty awesome. So I had my eye on getting something in here, and it's taken over 2 years, and we're here.
Okay, so how did the club scene for you start?
It started like 23 years ago, you know, by me wanting to dance and not finding the right spot. Because that many years ago, there weren't a lot of clubs around. So I opened my first club when I was 21, and it's been going since.
Okay. Now, I think what? This is your, what, 16th club per day?
Yes, this is actually number 15.
Oh, it's number 15. Yeah, but I know you're working on a 16 out there.
Well, I'm working on 16 and 17 and 18.
Yeah, but we're going to keep that hush-hush. Okay, let's go down memory lane for a moment. You started with a club called Club Z.
Yes, that was, again, 23 years ago. It was called Club Z. And that lasted for a few years. And I actually opened another club, and I ran two clubs for a while. And the rest is history, really. We've had quite a few.
When I was in university and he opened his Club Z club, my initiation was to get to his club, and it was kind of, it was a gay scene club. And I had to go in there and get a guy's number on a box of matches.
Well, it was quite mixed. I mean, back then, the first club I opened was more of an underground club, and that's how I started out.
So, know? Did you bring the house music to Toronto?
Actually, I was the first one to do any of the house music in Toronto. And I remember the first tunes we brought from the States. And it took a while, but we ended up being really the first ones, and we're still doing the biggest house music in the city.
Okay, after Club Z, let's say Charles opened another club, Still Life.
Yes, Still Life was the second club I opened. It was there for 8 years, and then I sold it, and you know, I've had quite a few since, and really, I've opened a few restaurants.
Yes.
And I own a hotel in the city as well, and a Hugo Boss store. So I've been trying to diversify. As long as it's within the entertainment industry, then I'm there. But definitely my preference is the nightclub business.
Okay, like he is the man that runs the scene. Okay, we're talking Club Z, we're talking Still Life, we're talking Boa, we're talking Ocean.
Yes. I mean, that was a high-end restaurant that was really one of the most exclusive ones. And in the last few years, I also started doing live shows. So I do about 120 live shows a year, everybody from Prince to NXS. So really what we do is everything from underground music to commercial, R&B, hip-hop, and house. And we do quite a few live shows every year. The new one coming up now, we have Pink playing for us in the next couple of months.
Okay. And before we go talk about Dragonfly here tonight, Charles has a multi-entertainment complex called The Government, and everybody who's anybody knows about this joint. Okay, now he has like 7 different rooms. It's amazing. And I go to this club all the time. This is the kind of club on some nights that the party goes on till 9 in the morning. And when I leave the club, I've left 4,000 people partying there. Charles, I see you up in the booth, up in the DJ booth, listening to the DJ, the hottest DJs from Deep Dish to Paul Oakenfold. And you're up in the booth watching the masses party. What are you thinking?
I just really love the energy. I mean, I really, my main concentration is making sure everybody that comes through leaves happy. And I like bringing the new trends and the new music to the city. And watching thousands of people dance and have a good time is really what really gets me going.
Okay, when you get home at 9, 10 in the morning, when do you sleep and what time do you wake up?
Well, I sleep on Sundays, so midweek is really not much sleep for me. But my energy level and my adrenaline is really what keeps me going.
Okay, you see how Charles' demeanor is very calm and cool? This is Charles. All of his nightclub, drama, chaos, madness outside. And this is Charles with a headset. One moment. And then everything just subsides and everything's okay for night. All right, let's talk about Dragonfly. How did the name Dragonfly come about?
Well, we wanted to do, being in a casino, we wanted to do something that has a bit of a theme, because I think of Vegas, and usually the clubs in Vegas have a theme. So we thought of an Asian theme, because Asian theme has a lot of sex appeal, has a lot of rich colors, a lot of texture, a lot of depth, everything from the history to the fabrics to the materials. So Dragonfly was the name we chose that would be fitting with the vibe of the club.
And what do you expect from this vibe? Because we're close to the border, we're not in Toronto anymore. What are you expecting from this club?
I expect a great mix of people everywhere from Canada and the States, from Buffalo, from Toronto, Hamilton, all over. I think we'll have a better mix here than we do in Toronto, and we'll have even a better energy, because what we're really bringing in has never been done anywhere around here. And it's definitely something to see.
What about the music scene? What do you bring in here tonight?
Tonight, really, we're playing a mixture of music. It's our opening night, so we're trying to keep everybody entertained. But every night we'll have a different theme, and Wednesday will be our house theme. And on the weekend, we'll be a little more on the R&B scene. But the music will definitely be diverse on different evenings.
What nights do you plan to open? Because casino here, aren't people here like 24/7?
Well, Tuesday night we do an industry night where we invite everybody from in the business, and we take care of them in a special way. And then Wednesday is our house night, and then Thursday, Friday, Saturday, we operate on a regular basis, and we'll be open every long weekend Sunday.
You know, look how dapper Charles is. Charles, tell us about your clothing.
I like to mix my clothing. I love fashion. I love clothes, and I. Anything really that relates to entertainment and energy and, you know, excitement. And that's why I ended up opening a Hugo Boss shop in Toronto, because of my love to the fashion.
Now, Hugo Boss, it's a venue where it's really important during the film festival, right?
Yes, we do quite a bit with the film festival. And usually all the venues we have downtown are quite involved with the film festival. And as a matter of fact, tomorrow one of the clubs called This Is London, we have a big show, a fashion show for Hugo Boss.
Hugo Boss. When I was at the film festival, he and his wife came outside the party and Gwyneth Paltrow rolled up and went in.
Well, we're lucky enough in Toronto to get a lot of press and a lot of people from the film industry. So we've gotten used to seeing a lot of stars, which is great.
So we talked about your clothing, we talked about your clubs, we talked about Charles the Man. If you don't know, look at him, he's like one of the best dancers in Toronto. But Dragonfly, it's going to be open, those days you talked about, this is your baby.
My newborn baby.
New baby.
And hopefully he'll grow up to be a great kid.
Yeah, so was this your dream to come close to the border like this?
My dream is to go across the border.
You got that Buffalo?
I'm getting close, who knows, we'll see what the crowd brings.
If you had to pick a couple of the states, where else would you go?
Vegas and Miami.
Really?
Yes.
Do you see Miami here tonight?
I see more Vegas here tonight, definitely.
Because of the casino.
Yeah, I think it's definitely more Vegas here tonight.
All right.